bird pun. It's a bird pun. Calm down, guys. Grow up.
Bird!
So for those who don't often branch out, that's another bird pun.
Bird!
Tuca and Bertie is an animated show about two best friends, a free-spirited toucan named Tuca, and a self-conscious song thrush named Bertie. Tuca is a recovering alcoholic who is 6 months sober and is trying to find herself. Bertie is a character who has aspirations, but her anxiety prevents her from reaching for them. The two characters are codependent on each other, and the end of the first season shows one of the reasons why. It's an adult animated show starring two female leads, and let's face it, this is sadly a very rare thing. Most of you will see the very obvious Bojack Horseman vibes in how this show looks. The creator of the show is Lisa Hannawalt. I really hope I've said your name right. Who was the designer and producer behind Bojack Horseman? Characters that are deeply human at their core in spite of being anthropomorphized animals. Even though the reason that anthro-animals live among humans isn't explained, and the characters are basically humans with animal heads stuck on, this show has anthro-plants too, which is weirdly bizarre, but I love it anyway. And even the public transport itself is a mixture of snakes and slugs. Like Bojack Horseman, on the surface, Tuca and Bertie has a very, juvenile quality to the visuals, in spite of it dealing with very adult themes. Unlike Bojack Horseman, though, it has a much more surreal tone. Tuca and Bertie, to me, is basically if Bojack Horseman and, say, Adventure Time got smooshed together and then had some pizza with Daria. It's not as cynical as Daria is, or as melancholic as Bojack Horseman is, but it's just as experimental, if not more experimental, than Adventure Time was. It also jumps into other mediums like stop motion and even sock puppetry at one point, and you know what? I barely even noticed any difference because of how surreal the show was already. If anything, I was actually expecting this.
Bird!
I find it refreshing to see the female body designed and animated in a way that doesn't sexualize them, even if there is a lot of nudity in this show. Nudity is not automatically sexy or pornographic. Nudity can be tasteful, but it can also tell a lot about a character and how comfortable they are, not only in their own skin, but how they feel when in social situations. There's an episode where Tuca flashes her date twice. And guess what? The guy doesn't like it. If anything, it's a huge turnoff for him. It's not that he doesn't find her attractive physically, because he clearly does, but the way she was all over the place with her behavior was a huge turnoff for him. He even compliments her about her breasts, but shock, shock, horror people, breasts are not sexual. Meanwhile, Bertie doesn't even like being nude in front of her own boyfriend, and yeah, there is a reason for that, which is revealed near the end of the season. One of Bertie's co-workers points out to her that her sweater is very tight, and insinuates that she wore a tighter sweater deliberately to get favors from her boss. So, her boob literally leaves her body after being sexually harassed. In spite of surrealistic thing about this, no one is going to watch this show to get an eyeful. Why? Because this show, unlike shows like Family Guy or The Simpsons, for example, it doesn't make sexual harassment into a joke. Instead, they make jokes out of the people that don't take sexual harassment seriously. The truth of the matter is, sexual harassment is never funny. No matter what gender you are, male or female, because males can be sexually harassed as well, if you are being harassed in any way, it needs to be brought to light. Let's admit it, women are often over-sexualized in cartoons, and it's icky. You know, back pain-inducing breasts, hips that defy all laws of physics and gravity. And where are her internal organs? Are they in her boobs? Because that would explain a lot. I should also point out that the male characters in this show are not all jerks. Sure, there's Dirk, who basically represents all the guys that are, cocks, because he's a rooster. But Bertie's boyfriend, Speckle, is a really sweet and naive guy, and he's also very loyal to Bertie. You could say that he's the best bra, because he's so supportive. Hey! Bertie's boss is also very understanding and caring. In fact, he's the one that tells Dirk to pack his things and go home early after Bertie confronts Dirk about his sexual harassment, and then it's revealed that he's been sexually harassing other female co-workers. But guess what? Not every female character takes her seriously when she reports it either. In fact, one of them defends Dirk for his behavior. Seriously, what?
Men!
It's not about women standing up to men. It's about people standing up for themselves in general, because, shock, shock, horror, women are people. The inner narration and thought bubbles are literal and can be interacted with, giving this show a very all cards on the table kind of feel. It's not tasteless, but it's not classy either. It's real and delicious. It's whimsical and vibrant, though I do wonder if it's accessible to those that aren't familiar with the style of Bojack Horseman. Because it took me a while to get into that show, but with this one, I got into it pretty quickly. But as expected from a show from the creator of Bojack Horseman, this show has a lot of weight to it. It's a stereotypical odd couple series, really, as in the ego character and the id character. It's a pretty traditional formula that the show clings to, but what sets this show apart from other odd couple shows or buddy comedies? It's not about differences, but rather about how both characters handle unpredictability or uncertainty. It takes a few episodes for this show to find its rhythm. There's no pop culture references in the show as such, even though it's set in a contemporary high-paced metropolis. I'd say this show has very universal appeal because it's a show about women made by a woman, but it's not a show just for women either. Anyone can relate to this show and how it conveys what it's like to live with social anxiety or low self-esteem. I highly recommend you guys to check out this show if you haven't already. You can watch it on Netflix. I'd love to hear what you guys think about it. Let me know in the comments below. In the meantime, I'm Mad Munchkin. Stay creative.